Good day. This is THB, the program of the Full Gospel Business and Fellowship International. I welcome you on the program. My name is Oluwakumi Adedeje. Today, I have brought a teacher to testify of the greatness of this living God, the power that is in God, what you can enjoy in God, the saving grace, the healing power, the deliverance power that is in God. My guest on the program today, she's a teacher by name, Mrs. Chinyere Ekuribe. You're welcome on the program.
Thank you, sir.
Why did you choose teaching and not nursing as a profession? And are you enjoying it now?
Really, I'm enjoying being a teacher. The reason I chose being a teacher was during my secondary school days. I had a teacher, a history teacher named Mrs. Bulye. The way the woman went about it, you know, we became jealous of her. She was so intelligent, smart, and then we all decided that we wanted to be like her. And since then, I've worked towards being a teacher.
Is there any regret?
No, I've not regretted.
And you're being paid well.
I'm being paid well now.
what do you mean by now?
Now.
When you joined, how much was your salary when you joined the teaching service?
When I joined, it was 95 naira.
Per day?
Per month.
But now you're using Ghana Must Go to the bank now.
Not actually Ghana Must Go.
But at least.
At least it's okay.
It's something.
It's something.
And that's what is bringing the smile.
Better than what it used to be.
Now, that's on a lighter mood. How did you decide that you want to spend your life with Jesus Christ? Why did you decide for Jesus?
I decided for Jesus when I was in the secondary school after my Western WAEC. Then we had, there was this crusade in Aba when Omabajeso came to hold a crusade. There on the crusade, I gave my life to Jesus. Since then, my life has never been the same.
Now, there is this story about healing. You came on this program one time and shared that healing power.
Yes.
I want you to say it again so that people will know that indeed Jesus is real.
Jesus has done a lot in my life. After my marriage in 1988, when I had my second baby, I felt ill. I never knew the cost of the sickness. I was taken to various, hospitals. No doctor could find out what was wrong with me. Until one day, when we went to Full Gospel meeting, there Gumba Osorolo ministered at that day. He said that everybody should ask the Lord to give him his own gift. Then that day I prayed and the Lord ministered healing to me. Not only that, the sickness persisted. But at the time, it was like I was dying until my husband took me to one pilgrim hospital. When I read the signpost, I said I was not going to enter. That is either God healed me or I will die instead of going into that place. Now we turn back. I had a ministration that I didn't know how the sickness came in and that I will not know how it will fizzle away. I held to that word, how it will fizzle away. And actually, through to God's word, the sickness fizzled away. I never took any drug. I never visited any doctor again. The sickness fizzled away by the word of the Lord.
And you're whole now?
I'm whole. The outcome of the healing was, the other children I had.
That's why I want to say that the outcome of the healing was the baby is coming.
Yes.
The power of God is available also to cause the enemy to be disgraced in your life. The power of God is available to make you smile like my guest on this program. The power of God is available to give you an experience about who Jesus is in your life. Now let's talk about your finances as a teacher. Have you seen God help you, especially those days when it was just a brown envelope, small money coming in?
Yes, the Lord really helped me in those days. Even before I married, my salary was nothing to write home about. But because Jesus was in my life, I was able to manage well, to plan. And at any point I'll be lacking, God will send somebody that will help me out. I held on to him because he said he will supply my needs according to his riches in glory through Christ Jesus. And he did. I experienced it in various ways. I never lacked any good thing. Even though with that, you know, meager salary, the Lord was seeing me through.
Now, how did you come to go for further studies, I mean, higher degree? What was it, through this meager income, or God does open a way?
The Lord actually opened the way. Before I married, I had only grade 2 certificate. Mm-hmm. Then after my marriage, through the help of my husband, I was sent to go and do my NCE. After the NCE, immediately I came back. My husband said, you must go and read for your degree. I went and read for my degree. After the degree, I relaxed, you know, teaching with that qualification until sometime 2003, I had an announcement of, you know, scholarship by the federal government. My husband asked me to go and obtain the form. I did. Never knew that I would be shortlisted. Mm. I prayed even the day we were going. I said, even if it's remaining one form, I will take it and I will be taking. I obtained the form, fill it, send it to Abuja. And my name was shortlisted without even knowing. One day my husband came and brought a letter that I was invited for the interview. I went to the interview. There on the interview ground, a lot of people were discouraged me. Some said they had attended the interview twice, some said thrice. I said, my case is a different case. Because I'm a Zion daughter, I will be favored by God. And on reaching there, I went, sat before the panel, and before I got up, I just peeped and saw them wrote recommended. So as I was getting up, they said, madam, we are finished with you. I said, thank you very much. I'm grateful. Thank you very much. He said, why are you saying thank you very much? Do you know if you have taken? I said, I have been taken. I know, I'm sure that I've been taken. Thank you very much. So they all laughed. I went away. After some time, I got a letter that I've been, you know, taking to read my MSc at University of Uyo.
And so I'm sure another letter is coming for PhD. Will you take that?
I will very much. I'll be pleased to receive it.
Oh my God. You see, the favor of God is available for you. God is said to locate you wherever you are. You don't have to buy your way out. God will grant you favor. Do you remember what the scripture talked about Jesus in Luke? He says, and the child grew in favor with God and with man. Opportunity is here today for you to grow in favor with God and with man. And the power of God is going to come into your life, and the grace of God will be seen over your life. We're going on break very shortly. And when we're back, I want you to sit back. My guest on the program is going to share again the delivering power of God right in the coven of the enemy. God is at work even in your life also. We'll be right back. God bless you.
The Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship International is a vast global movement of laymen, businessmen, and professionals comprising millions of men being used mightily by God to bring this last great harvest through the outpouring of God's Holy Spirit before the return of the Lord Jesus Christ. Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship International. the happiest people on earth.
Welcome back on the program. This is THB, the program of the Full Gospel Business Fellowship International. My guest on the program has been Mrs. Chinyere Ekwuribe. You're welcome back on the program.
Thank you, sir.
You're sharing about the power of God and the opportunity that God gave you to go for higher degree. In what area, what discipline did you obtain that scholarship for?
I obtained the scholarship to read clothing and textile technology.
What does that entail? Does it mean that you can design dresses now or what?
I can construct fabric, bring it to usable stage. I can design them whichever way, whether furnishing or dresswear or wrapper, I can do it very well.
So which one will you prefer? A scholarship to establish an industry or a scholarship to go for a PhD?
Scholarship to go for PhD. I'm a teacher by profession and a teacher to the course. So
you don't want to be an industrialist?
I want to teach others so that I will see the avenue of imparting my knowledge to others.
That's interesting. But Ma, there is this story about God seeking you out from the coven of the enemy. Let our audience have an idea of what actually happened.
Thank you very much. Well, it was in one of the occasions I was traveling from Omaha to Uyo. During the time I was still writing my thesis, I had finished my coursework then. That was 2006, to be precise, by February. That day, I traveled from Omaha to Uyo. And each time I would travel, I would always like to minister in the vehicle. That day, the topic I ministered on was drawing near to God. And after the ministration, a lot of people, was interested and they gave their life to Christ. I prayed with them. When we came to the park, we all bidded ourselves farewell. I went to the campus, get to my room. I discovered that none of my roommates had, come to school because the room was just empty, dirty. I closed the room back. I prayed, closed the room, went out to where I had already told them that I was coming to search for information in the internet. At Barrack Road, 74 Barrack Road. So on coming out from the gate, I met a woman from Ebonyi State. The woman asked me to come and take some fruit. I told the woman I was going somewhere. When I come back, I will come to her. The woman said, okay. I boarded a bike. So the bike took me. After a short distance, few poles, the man said, mommy, sorry, I had a puncture tire. Please, could you board another one? I said, no problem. As I tried to give the bike man money, he said, no, mommy, use it to board another one. No problem. I thanked the young man and stopped another one. Without knowing that this particular one was the wrong one, I entered. Before we could get to few posts again, we now saw that another bike man, an old man this time, carrying somebody. And the old man was asking this one that was carrying me that the man should direct him to where he was going. The man refused, the one that was carrying me refused. But I looked at him and said, seeing that this one was an old man, and he was desperate, he was looking desperate. I pleaded with this particular one that was carrying me. I said, are you not a human being? Please direct him. He said, you want me to direct him? I said, yes, I want you to direct him. He said, okay. Now, since you wanted me to direct him, we will take a diversion. I said, no problem, provided you direct this man. Because they said, the old man said, he was taking the one he was carrying to a convention of a particular church, I don't know. Then I said, please, since it's a church and it's, church activity, direct him. I didn't know that that was when I played myself into trouble.
It was a network.
It was a network. So the man agreed. I said, okay, allow me to take. I said, I oblige you. Go ahead. Took me. I never knew. The man just zoomed off. Was running to, you know, one bush way. I said, ah, where are you going this? He said, mommy, relax. Don't worry. When we get there, we'll still branch out where you are going. I said, okay. The man went off. Before I knew it, we had already gone far. I couldn't shout. I couldn't scream. I now held my peace. I said, okay, carry me to wherever. So we now went to where they wanted to carry me. Mm-hmm. I now discovered that I've gone into their hand and into their shrine. They were, you know, forcing me, come down, do this, do the other one. But I said, don't touch me. Whatever you want to take, take. Don't touch me. That was what I told them. They said, okay, come into this place. I went. So their priest came out. The person they called their priest came out. And they started making, you know, all sort of incantation. At the time, they said, madam, repeat after him. I didn't talk. Madam, do this. I never talked to them. I was praying inside of me. I was singing and praying because I knew I was in trouble. And I started reminding God. I said, God, remember, I ministered your word in the vehicle. Remember, I am a Zion daughter, and I can't be molested this way. Remember, I am the apple of your eyes, and you cannot allow me to suffer shame and humiliation. So as I was saying all those things, I was caught up. I started speaking in tongues as I was singing.
Right in their shrine.
Right in their shrine. Though in that shrine, I was hearing noise, but could not see anybody. So it was at that time the Spirit of God came high on me. I went out of that place. They said, where are you going? Come back. Where are you? I didn't mind them. I was walking around there, but I never saw where the noise was coming from. I was hearing the noise. All the things they were doing, I was not interested because I was focused. As I was praying, I started shouting, screaming, where is your priest? Go and call your priest. Because before then, the priest had left the scene. He went out. I started shouting, call your priest, call that person you call your priest. I want to see him, come here, you know. The priest maybe heard my voice and came and said, who brought this certain woman here? Who brought this certain woman? I looked at the priest, I said, it's you that is the certain man. Then I now started telling, I said, if you fail to repent and desist from this act, the anger of God will soon come upon you and you must be consumed and destroyed. Repent if you want to live and stop this nonsense. They said, madam, we don't hear. We hear you, we hear you. I beg, come out. I said, I'm not leaving this place. I will not leave. Bring all the things you collected from me. I want to see them. Mm. So they brought my bag, brought the money they collected. I looked at them. I said, go and bring the exact denomination you collected from me. I'm not touching this. They went back and said, bring. They brought the money. I looked at it. It was the denomination they collected. I was sure it was in my bag. I counted it. They overgave me by 100 naira. I just threw it on them. I said, this is not my money. He said, okay, madam, we don't hear. Come out. And I said, I'm not leaving. You brought me here. And you are the person that is going to take me out. Come and take me out. Come on, come and take me out here. They now called that bike man that carried me, said, if you know where you brought this woman, take her out. The man came and took me out. So my intention was when we get to where people were, that I will raise alarm. But unfortunately for
the bike man,
and unfortunately for me, they never get to where people where the man stopped me on the way. Because the first place he wanted to stop me, I refused. I resisted him. Then he took me further. And we are seeing, you know, residential building somehow. The man said, madam, if you don't go stop, I will throw you that. I said, you cannot do that. The man stopped. Then I came down from the bike. The man zoomed off. I knelt down there. Worship the Lord. Mm. Worship the Lord. I said, God, you are too much. You are a God that can be trusted on. You are my refuge, you are my fortress. In you, I'll continue to put my trust.
Amen.
There, I now started walking down. I left that place. Now, on reaching my school, now at that gate, that woman I told I was coming,
okay.
Because this thing took, you know, between a period of 3 hours, between 3 and 4 hours, because I really spent time with them there. So when I now saw the, I met the woman again, I asked the woman, do you know where I'm coming from? He said, yes, you have stayed long. Where did you go? You stayed long. I now narrated the story to the woman. The woman said, are you true? Are you sure? Is it true that this happened? I said, yes. The woman, you know, tried to touch me. She will pinch me to see if I'm really a human being. I said, I'm a human being. I really went there. I said, what happened? I said, is Jesus in me? Is that Jesus that I've been talking about that delivered me from the hands of this one? He said, did they touch you? Did they? Because I said, they didn't do anything to me. Rather, all the things they collected from me, I collected back. They didn't do anything. He said, And at that point, I started ministering to the woman. I introduced Jesus to this woman. The woman said, I believe you. If you could go there and come out, because nobody ever went there and came out scotch-free. I said, you have seen one today. It's Jesus. So I thank God. This God has been faithful. This God, not only this, God has delivered us several times from armed robbers. You know, they have, you know, visited where we are living formerly several times, but they never penetrated into our house. It is the Lord's doing.
What a great story.
Yeah.
It is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. Do you hear that? It is the Lord's doing, and it's marvelous in our eyes. The scripture talks about him not sleeping or slumber. That is God, and that's why we are giving you the opportunity over this program today. Don't allow anybody to give you any institution. Don't allow anybody to give you native insurance. What you need is in Jesus. He will keep you. He will keep you. He says, though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you will fear no evil. Bow your heart at this time and make a covenant with Jesus today so that your name also will be on the hollow of his hand. Say these prayers after me sincerely from your heart. Sincerely, and the peace of God will be yours today. Lord Jesus, thank you. I sincerely open my heart and ask you to please come into my life. Be the Lord of my life. I'm ready to say bye-bye to sin and iniquity. I'm ready to be delivered from the hand of the enemy. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. I announce that you are the Lord of my life as from today. In Jesus' name, amen. That's it. You've gotten the foundation of the hand of God in your life. Let us know of your intention. Tell us. And one day I believe that you will come also to testify about the saving power of God. I sincerely want to thank you, ma, for coming.
Thank you,
it's
sir.
It's wonderful having you on.
Thank
you, coming
sir.
The second time on this program. The next time you're coming, it's going to be Dr. Mrs.
Yes.
Chinyere Ikwiriri.
Yes, yes.
God is going to promote you also. Expect his touch this week. It's going to be wonderful. Expect us again next week. Another person is going to come to testify that Jesus is indeed the Lord of our life. Bye, and God bless you.